Hello friends, in the today's video we are going to see about the Kerberos authentication service version 5. So in the last Kerberos version part 1 video we have seen about the Kerberos version 4 and its authentication dialog. Now the remaining thing is that is the comparison between the Kerberos version 4 and the version 5. So, with respect to the introduction to the Kerberos, once again we'll revise it. That is, it is an authentication service which is developed as for Project Athena at MIT. It is used as a central mutual authentication protocol and which authenticates users to the server and the servers to the users. Now, it is based on the central authentication server. Which consists of the authentication server AS and the TGS, that is ticket granting server. Now, with respect to the encryption it is going to use, it is using that is symmetric encryption and it is based on the NIDM scoder protocol. Now, with respect to the versions of the Kerberos, it is having two versions, namely which are popular. One it is version 4, it is most widely used version, and version 4 uses DS. Whereas version 5 corrects the security deficiency of the version 4. And let us see about the version 5, the comparison between the Kerberos version 4 and the version 5. Now in this diagram it is visible that when the user logons to the workstation and requests the services from the Kerberos server. So it can be any kind of service like FTP, Telnet, or any on the Windows 2000 server. These Kerberos authentication services used for authenticating the users. So user will request the ticket granting ticket will be provided, then service granting ticket. Now user wants to access the services of this server. For that purpose, it is going through the Kerberos. So Kerberos is a trusted third party, which is called as a KDS, which is called as a Key Distribution Center. So this dialog already we have discussed. So I will not discuss much on this scenario wherein ticket granting ticket is requested, then service granting ticket is requested, and the request for the service. So per service session, this is being carried out. Now the Kerberos version 5, it was developed in 1990s, mid 1990s, and it is a standard which is RFC 1510, and it has some improvements over the version 4. So now let us compare the differences between the version 4 and the version 5. First is the encryption system dependence. The encryption system algorithm which is used in the version 4, it is based on the TES. Whereas the version 5, it is using AES, mostly Advanced Encryption Standard. In version 5, the ciphertext is tagged with the encryption type identifier. That means any kind of encryption technique can be used over there. Encryption keys are tagged with the type and length. So different algorithms can be used in the version 5, not necessarily only TES. Now, with respect to the network protocol, that is the internet protocol dependence is there in the version 4. That is, the version 4 requires use of the IP addresses only. Whereas other address which are there, that is ISO network addresses, are not supported by the version 4. Whereas in the version 5, it can support any network address type, which are tagged with the type and the length. With respect to the byte ordering, again there is a difference. In version 4, the sender of the message employ byte ordering of its own byte ordering is being specified, choosing and tags the message in the to indicate LSB in the lowest address or MSB in the lowest address. So least significant bytes or most significant bytes in the lowest address, such kind of addressing scheme or byte order addressing is done. Whereas in the version 5, the byte ordering, which is considering the ASN 0.1 rules and basic encoding rules, BER, which is provided an unambiguous byte ordering by version 5. Now, in case of the version 4, with respect to the ticket lifetime, the lifetime values in the version 4 are encoded in 8-bit quantity in units of 5 minutes. So every particular ticket lifetime, it is based on the units of 5 minutes. 5 minutes, which is there, lifetime of 5 minutes is there, and maximum it can be 24 hours in the units of 5 minutes. Whereas the ticket lifetime in case of the version 5, it is continuous and it has arbitrary lifetimes, which are indicated by the start and the end times. So tickets are having arbitrary lifetime, and these are the continuous, not in the units of 5 minutes as that in the version 4. Now, with respect to the authentication forwarding, version 4 does not allow credentials issued to one client to be forwarded to some another client, host or client, which is there. So authentication forwarding is not supported in the version 4, whereas in the version 5 it is supported. That is, for example, client wants to request to print server and then access client's file from the file server. So print server first and then the file server, wherein the authentication forwarding of the client is being carried out. That is, client as credentials are used for forwarding over there, or from one server to the another server. So this is supported in the version 5, whereas in the version 4 it is not supported. With respect to the interim authentication, so now I have already explained about the interim authentication. That is, when multiple rims, the Kerberos server in one rim wants to communicate with the Kerberos server in the another rim. That is, the client in one rim wants to access the server in the another rim. At that particular point, there are multiple N rims are communicating. The Kerberos server in one rim is communicating with the Kerberos server in the another rim. That is, N rims are communicating, and therefore it is N square Kerberos to Kerberos relationships are there, which are unnecessary in case of the version 4, and these are being corrected in case of the version 5, wherein it is having fewer relationship for the interim authentication. So these are some of the differences with respect to the environmental shortcomings. Also, in this differences, we have some technical deficiencies with respect to different versions. So now the first, that is with respect to the technical deficiencies, is the double encryption. So in version 4, if you are using the version 4, it requires the clients to encrypt the ticket twice. So once with the secret key of the target server and then again with the secret key known to the client. Two times encryption is being carried out. This second encryption is not necessary and wasteful in case of the Kerberos versions. So therefore, Kerberos version 5 does not uses it. Now, in version 4, again PCVC encryption is used. That is, the encryption in version 4 makes non-standard mode of DES, which is called as PCVC, which is propagating cipher block chaining. It is demonstrated that this mode is vulnerable to an attack, and therefore it PCVC was not should not be used over there. And version 5 provides explicit integrity mechanism. That is, standard CBC mode is being used for the encryption in case of the version 5. Now, with respect to the session keys, there are again the differences with respect to the keys which are being used. The same key is used repeatedly to gain a service from a particular server. So that is, the same key is used in case of the version 4, and it may be a risk that attacker can replay messages from an old session. Old session messages can be replaced. That is, a replay attack can be carried out in case of the version 4. Whereas in the version 5, it is this attack can be avoided by using a new sub-session key every time whenever the connection is being established, or whenever the session is being established, a new session key which will be used in case of the Kerberos version 5. So this is with respect to the session keys, and therefore these differences can which are there, that is deficiencies which are there in the Kerberos version 4, that can be improved in case of the version 5. The last one which is there, that is the password attacks. So both versions are vulnerable to password attack. That is the message from the authentication server to the client, which is including the material encrypted with the key based on client's password. The opponent can capture this message and attempt to decrypt it by trying various passwords. So this is the same type of password attack which we have discussed. Version 5 does not provide a mechanism which is known as a pre-authentication, which should make password attacks more difficult. So therefore, the both versions are vulnerable to the password attacks. So these are the differences, that is between the version 4 and the version 5, and the technical deficiencies with respect to the both versions. Now let's summarize it. That is the strengths of the Kerberos. So user passwords are never sent across the network. It is sent in the encrypted form. Secret keys are only passed across the network. Client and server systems are mutually authenticated, client to server and server to the client. Authentications are reusable and durable, and it is being scrutinized by many of the top programmers, cryptologists, and the security experts in the industry. So, this we have learned about the Kerberos version 4 and the version 5 differences. Thanks for watching the video.